to speak today on something so important to our family is amazing, so thank you for that. When I started to list, really think about today and list what Medicaid does for our family, the list kept going on, and it was more than I even have thought about in years. Emma's 14, and she is born with a very, very rare seizure disorder from birth. I guess they called it devastating, is what it was titled, and they don't know much about it, but it has left Emma globally delayed in, she doesn't walk or talk, and she has full care needs. But that aside, she also has the sweetest personality, and I'm hoping she wakes up here so you can actually see her this morning. The types of services that we receive.
It's Monday, so that happens a lot.
I know. I was thinking she's just the one that gets away with it. And the dog, too. As I just go down literally the list of things that we get funded through Medicaid, it includes her diapers, her prescriptions, her medical equipment, her bed that she has right now, her wheelchair, her stander, her shower and potty chair that she needs, her extra large car seat. All of these things that she had when she was little, we could get away with the typical things that young children need. As soon as our children get older enough, they can't do those things anymore, and yet they still need those things. We rely on Medicaid to help us with those things. We soon will be needing a new wheelchair. I was just told by her therapist she's outgrowing it. I thought we had a couple more years, but we don't. And a lift. She's getting too heavy to transport, and we have nursing at home, and she already exceeds the limit they should be lifting. So that is on the summer's agenda, is to try and get a lift into our home. Her MAFOs, which are her leg braces that help her stand and walk, those are needing changed often as she grows. They cover that. Doctor appointments and medical services, hospitalization and blood work and all the things Emma needs done. And one of the big ticket items is the nursing care that Emma requires. And when I looked at that list, I thought, wow. Often I think Medicaid is thought of something generally for maybe low-income families, or you know, it's kind of a mindset. And it's just not the case. It's to help children with disabilities that come from any kind of family. My husband and I both have jobs. I have excellent insurance. I'm a teacher. I have great insurance for my whole family. It's not enough. They do not cover the majority of what I just read to you. The types of things.
Would you mind, after this is over, can you send us that list?
Absolutely.
It's helpful to have that kind of.
Absolutely.
I'm not sure anyone in Washington has that list.
Wow.
And I didn't have it before a few minutes ago.
It's our every day. I can't do without any one of those things. It's not even, we'd have to find a way. I don't know what we would do, but we'd have to find a way. They're not negotiable. These aren't the extras to make our life easier. They are Emma's necessities for her life to have a quality of life. And my husband and I have tried to do a lot on our own. That's just our nature. We have a lot of family support. We're very independent. I've had people say, wow, you haven't used this service or this service yet. We try to do as much as we can by ourselves. We just can't do all those things that I listed without Medicaid. We just can't. No matter what we can give our daughter, we need Medicaid. There's no question about it, even with good jobs and good insurance. It's a huge, huge important part of Emma's life. The nursing, and I listed, when I made my list, I was trying to go back and circle the things that my insurance doesn't cover at all, because a lot of times Medicaid's just coming up and covering the back end of what my insurance didn't cover. My insurance does cover the basic care for Emma, the medical appointments, the pediatrician visits, but a lot of times Medicaid will just come along the back and cover the rest of those things. But when I actually went through my list and listed the things my insurance won't touch, that list was longer than I thought. Nursing. Emma did Ugro daycare, a typical daycare, her whole, until she was 12. We did not go the nursing route. She went to a typical daycare when I worked. And as soon as she turned 12, they loved her, but they said, she's 12, we can't keep her anymore. A 12-year-old that's typical can stay home after school for an hour alone. Emma cannot. I needed help. Nursing is covered through Medicaid. A nurse comes to our home every day and watches Emma for anywhere from an hour to 3 hours until I return home from work. And the days that Emma doesn't have school, but I do, I have a nurse in the home. My insurance won't touch that, and I don't know what we would do without that care for her. I want to keep my job. She was in a crib until she was 10 because there wasn't a safe alternative. She has seizures at night. They render her very stronger than I ever thought this child could be during a very potent seizure. A bed with side rails wasn't even an option. When we would go to a hotel and we sleep with her or to a friend's house, we'd actually physically sleep with her and we'd put a bed rail on the other side. If she had a seizure, her leg would just poke right through between the mattress and the bed rail. I have to sleep at night. I need to be able to know she's safe. Medicaid paid for something called a sleep safe bed. It's amazing. My insurance wouldn't touch it. It was a $7,000 bed that we could not have afforded on our own. And she sleeps alone every night, and I don't have to. I get my sleep. I do have a video monitor, but when she seizes at night, it's just an extra safe. It's like a hospital bed, but it looks like a typical bed. They covered it completely. That bed gets us our sleep every night, and I know she's safe. They even have plexiglass sides so that when I put the sides up, she doesn't feel like she's in a cage. An amazing piece of equipment. But these things are usually very expensive because they're obviously not everyone needs them. So the cost of medical equipment is really high because it's such specialty items. So Medicaid covers those things. Emma takes 7 prescriptions every day. Now my insurance has a prescription plan, but it's not going to cover. I'm ordering meds from the pharmacy weekly. We have deliveries weekly for Emma, and that does not even include her vitamins and supplements. Her dental care is covered, the basics, through my insurance. Emma's teeth are a real problem. They're even more of a problem sometimes than her seizures. They just come through with cavities and infections. She's already been hospitalized for her teeth. We have a phenomenal dentist who, instead of always putting her in the hospital to put her asleep to work on her teeth, which is standard a lot of times for these kiddos, he works very hard to just try and do it with nitrous, and we hold her a special way. And she's only been in the hospital once for dental care, and Gateway will cover that, the Medicaid will cover that, my insurance won't touch it. We see the dentist every 3 months instead of twice a year. My insurance said, no, we're not covering that. So there are so many medical needs that she has that go beyond what your typical insurance would cover. And the only other thing I wanted to mention, certain equipment that we need in the home to care for her, they may or may not deem it necessary. Just, no, we're not going to cover that. Medicaid will kick in and cover it. As I said earlier, all of these things for Emma are essentials. They're not extras. And without Medicaid, these essentials that Emma needs for everyday living wouldn't be covered. I don't know what we would do. So I can't even hardly think about Medicaid not being there.
Gwen, thank you. And you shouldn't have to be uncertain or worried about it. I'll leave other comments for later, but that's one of the parts about this whole debate that enrages me is there shouldn't be any uncertainty about this. Like not even a half an hour of uncertainty. But that's what some are proposing. So I appreciate you sharing all that. It's critically important information, especially as we go into the next 2 to 3 weeks.
Well, whatever you want me to do, I'll do. There's nothing we won't do to have our voices heard. This is important to our family.